This is the Oil Field Report with Jason Spiess.
Welcome to the Oil Field Report. My name is Jason Spiess, an award-winning multimedia journalist. And on today's episode of the Oil Field Report, we talk with Erik Hatch, the owner of Hatch Coaching and Hatch Real Estate, about a variety of topics, including sales growth, expanding into other marketplaces, and how having faith has allowed his business to grow exponentially. Erik Hatch is the owner of Hatch Realty, Coaching with Hatch, and he also has his financial fingers in a couple other companies and projects. Erik Hatch has transformed the real estate industry with a modern business model that has achieved recognition from the Wall Street Journal, Inc. magazine, and was endorsed by the Shark Tank's Barbara Corcoran. Erik Hatch has also spoke at numerous events, including TEDx's. In just a moment, our exclusive interview with Erik Hatch. But first, I would like to take a moment and thank our fine sponsors. Please support our sponsors, folks. They literally keep our lights on.
The Oil Field Report is sponsored by
Junior Urias, owner and operator of Up and Smoke Barbecue. He's been a barbecue master for decades in West Texas. Junior was the 2014 Barbecue Pitmaster Texas champion, and he loves to outseason the competition every chance he gets. Up and Smoke Barbecue and Junior Urias. Erik Hatch is in the business of helping others, and in this case, that means helping companies create wealth and abundance. Hatch speaks on workplace culture, honesty in the workplace, transparency, faith, compassionate capitalism, and many other topics that will grow your business. CoachingWithHatch.com. That's CoachingWithHatch.com. Lashaw Drill understands the importance of what we do every day. Their customers understand it too. The men and women of Lashaw Drill believe in the mission of American energy independence. And they believe in their people, and they believe in their country. Lashaw Drill.
And now, back to the Oil Field Report with host Jason Spiess.
Welcome back to the Oil Field Report. My name is Jason Spiess. Up next, our exclusive interview with Erik Hatch, owner of Hatch Realty and Coaching with Hatch.
Erik Hatch, owner of Hatch Realty.
All right, so let's start off by getting just an update on Hatch Realty. What's going on these days? You know, I mean, obviously you guys are seasonal, but talk to me about what's going on with Hatch. You're not seasonal. What am I talking about? Hang on. Let me start over. I was going to do the upcoming season. Then I thought, no, I'm not going to do that because I want timelessness. But anyway. All right. How about an update on Hatch Realty? What's happening with you guys these days?
We have been continuing to grow. We've been on a nice crescendo of taking a little more market share and impacting as many lives as possible. And so we're approaching real estate differently than what I think a lot of other people do, and we're doing so with an all-in team approach. So when you hire one of us, you actually get about 40 of us working in different corners and facets to make sure that you have a seamless transaction. And so we're taking that model, and as we're growing in Fargo, we've also seen some nice growth in our Detroit Lakes area and in Minneapolis, and we will also be opening up in Grand Forks, North Dakota, in the fall of 2017.
So you're looking at Fargo, Detroit Lakes, Minneapolis, and Grand Forks, is that right?
Yeah, you know, we believe that we have the capacity and the talent and the passion and drive to be a global company, and that global starts with local. And so we're going local, and then we're going regional. So we think that probably by 2020, we expect to be in, I'd say, 15 to 20 different markets around the upper Midwest.
That's great. That's outstanding. Let's talk about your idea and how you kind of branch that into a additional company, if you will, Hatch Coaching, in just a moment. But the thing that kind of ties it together, the radio show. Are you still doing the real estate radio show these days?
I am, yeah. Thanks to you, Jason. You pushed me 5 or 6 years ago to get on radio, and no other realtor in the area was doing it. And it has been a staple for our business now, and a cornerstone piece in what we're doing, because we're seen as the voice of real estate for the community, and as well as that gives us some great exposure and connection to people who who are driving to church on a Sunday morning or hanging out in the shop or on the road or just having coffee and reading the paper. So we're excited to be a part of people's lives, and we get invited into their worlds literally and figuratively through Real Estate Radio.
You know, it's funny you say Cornerstone, because the way that you've handled that program is differently than some people could have. For example, you kind of use it as an accountability piece within your organization, because you talk about helping the community. You talk about helping people with their real estate needs. You talk about how it really impacts you on a daily life. So I've always looked at it as you've taken the opportunity of your radio program and used it as an accountability piece, as opposed to, hey, here's some homes for sale and here's what they are, that sort of thing. Have you ever acknowledged that? Or was that part of your strategy?
It's not what I had defined early on in my career. It wasn't what I intended to do. It just felt more natural to talk about passions and things that were value-giving rather than trying to use it as a sales platform. And I've used that same approach now with our social media efforts and the things that we do. It's fun. If you follow Hatch Realty on social media or if you watch what I do, we're not talking about individual houses. I mean, occasionally we'll talk about a house that's for sale, and we'll talk about some market trends, but we usually just show the heartbeat of our company and the things that we're really fired up for and the stuff that we care about. And it's insane the law of attraction that's brought, because we're not trying to sell someone. We instead are saying, here's who we are and here's what we care about. And by the way, we sell houses. And whether it's our Real Estate Radio show or our social media platform, or even when you meet us face-to-face, nobody wants to be sold. I think that people want to be listened to, and that people want to be heard, and then we should collaborate together to see if there's a solution of how we can help you buy or sell a home, if that's one of your needs. But if not, we just want to be important in people's lives and bring value however we can.
Erik Hatch, owner of Hatch Realty, as well as Hatch Coaching, and we're going to talk about that in just a second. But first, I want to make sure that I acknowledge Erik Hatch has won awards from the Wall Street Journal. Inc. Magazine was a fastest growing company. What was the Inc. Magazine one again, Erik?
We were the number two fastest growing company in the state of North Dakota.
Okay, and then also has been endorsed by the Shark Tank's Barbara Corcoran. And a lot of that is...
Jason, we're also now endorsed by Gary LaVox, lead singer of Rascal Flatts. So there's another one for you.
Did you say the lead singer of Rascal Flatts?
Of course I did, yeah.
That's awesome. Yeah.
So we have a commercial. Rascal Flatts wrote a song years ago called I'm Moving On, and Gary LaVox takes that audio track and ties it with a really cool radio ad for us. And so I got to meet Gary a few weeks ago, and what a charming and charismatic man he is. And to have his endorsement is really great. The country followers, people who love country music, are pretty loyal and diehard. And so to have an endorsement for that corner of our world is a great player and help for us too.
Okay, so this is a fantastic, because this is going to spill into my next point, which is one of the reasons why you've been able to extend your brand to beyond Hatch Realty into Hatch Coaching and speaking is because of your creative personality, your creative mind, and how to really, what's the word that marketing people use? Experiential. So you're able to actually engage and connect with the audiences like nobody else. And doing things like this really is another example. You know, we're going to talk about Hatch Stock as well, but first talk to me about Hatch Coaching, because your ability to engage and connect with an audience really allowed you to spill over into helping your colleagues in creating a new model and a new system for their sales departments. Or am I kind of on the right page here with that? Is that what you're doing these days with Hatch Coaching?
I appreciate the inquiry. Hatch Coaching had stemmed from an original desire. I love to teach. I love to share. But I wasn't sure that I could be validated in that world. I think that the interesting thing about smaller communities and in the upper Midwest, it's all small communities for the most part, It's hard to be a prophet in your own land. And yet when I found in the real estate realm, I had people from all around the country and North America reach out to me and try to say, how did we do what we do? Our team is one of the top 57 teams in the country for production. And so, and we got there in a ridiculously short amount of time. And so people have asked, how do we do what we do? And it seemed to be a great natural connection that I could teach it and share it and coach it. And what we found is that I really got validated in that world. But it wasn't because of production, Jason. That was the funny thing is I wasn't validated because of our ability to sell a lot of houses, although that was proof in the pudding. People have been drawn to us, and the coaching that I do now is based on how to be a better leader, how to empower people and not just delegate your stuff to them, how to keep a high retention rate of people, how to avoid turnover in your organization, how to have a business that has meaning and purpose and value and those things that folks are really craving to be a part of. And so we talk about how to be better leaders, how to be better business people, how to have character in what we're doing. And don't get me wrong, Jason, I am a hot mess. I mean, I can't believe that some people listen to me for advice because I don't even take half my own advice, you know? But there is this fascinating world right now that is lining up, and I now have a demand line out the door for people to coach with me personally. And that's a really great opportunity. And so what we're doing is we're trying to figure out how to scale that. I have another coach in my company who is fantastic at what he does. But we're trying to figure out how can we really reach the masses. And so locally we're doing some summits and some seminars and some breakouts for people in our community. And then on a larger scale, we're doing summits and masterminds and get-togethers. We were out in San Diego earlier this month teaching people how to essentially have better systems and strategies in their company. We'll have over 100 people come to Fargo this fall that'll come to learn and grow together with us. And we're developing a series of webinars and YouTube videos and other things to just try to bring some value to people.
Do you got a website? Do you got something that people can go to check out? And what type of information can people go and kind of take a look at that whole Hatch coaching side of things?
Yeah, coachingwithhatch.com, very literal, very easy, coachingwithhatch.com. Jason, we even developed a board game of a sort. It kind of looks like a Cards Against Humanity pack, which is funny and ironic in and of itself. But when you open it up, it's a role-playing game for people, and it's designed for realtors, but we actually think that we've stumbled upon something that can be used in every industry. Think of the series of books that are like the Four Dummies. There's radio for dummies and real estate for dummies and computer programming for dummies. And that's basically, it gives guidelines of how to do well in that area. And this role-playing game is similar to that, is we're giving different types of personalities, people who are dominant or people who are great with detail, folks who are aggressive or social or anything in between. And then we're giving you real estate scenarios of are you buying, are you selling, are you working at an open house, or are you an internet lead or anything in between. And then we're giving motivation tools as well. And we take these different cards, and with those cards, you're developing ways to role play and to practice. What happens in this industry, and far too many industries, is that we end up practicing on our clients. And that's really an unfair thing to those people who are taking the risk of working with us, is we shouldn't be there to practice on them, but instead we need to practice on how to be better listeners and how to mirror and match people. Because, Jason, guys like you and I are pretty dominant and pretty social. We love being face-to-face with people. We love energizing. But quite often those folks who are slow and meticulous and great with detail are turned off to us. And so what we need to do is we need to practice mirroring and matching those people, and we need to show up as they are. So we need to move slower and be more intentional with our energy and to do a much better job of listening, because it's not about us. It's always about them. It's always about them. And so we've developed a game as well. And coachingwithhatch.com gives you a chance to buy that game, or you can inquire on how we can create that for your industry.
And so obviously when you take a look at this card game, that's thinking outside the box. That's creative thinking. And that's one of the things that I've noticed that you've been able to connect with people, because you do, you on a variety of different levels. And so let's circle back to your real estate world and get to your annual event called Hatch Stock, which is just a genius idea in my mind, you know. But it's a little bit more than just a marketing tool, is it? Because, I mean, the lengths that you go to is you want to make sure that people are having a good time, isn't it, Erik?
You know, it's the cornerstone of our business. Is the less I do real estate and the less as a company we do real estate, the more real estate we have to do. Now, of course, that means, yes, we have to jump in to get caught up in the work, but the law of attraction has been, as we've taken great care of people and been more of a community center and a chamber of commerce in our world, we've allowed folks to come to us to find opportunity. We're building a website right now called hatchknowsaguy.com. So if you need to be connected to a plumber or an electrician or somebody who sells beds or anything in between, we want to develop those relationships to be an introduction piece. Again, we're a community center for people, and Hatchstock is exactly that, is we're a place for folks to come and kick off summer, to celebrate their community, to have some fun, to enjoy a beautiful first Friday in June. And the timing of it's really nice, because June 2nd is our event, 5 to 10 p.m. at our parking lot in Fargo. And we're expecting 1,500 to 2,000 people, Jason. And it's a four-free event. It's live music from the Moody River Band, featuring Tom Peckscamp, who is a superb musician. And then we have Tiger Lily, who is very North Dakota famous for what they're doing. And so they're taking the main stage and are going to entertain the crowd all night long. There's free food from Barbacoa, which is a fantastic restaurant just next door to us. And then we have inflatable games for kids or very nimble adults. We have kids' food as well if they're not into the delicious tacos from Barbacoa. And the only thing that you have to pay for the whole night long is if you want something to drink from the cash burner. Otherwise, we just throw a party for people, Jason. We call it Hatchstock because I throw my name on everything. It's our marketing move, but it's also funny and ironic, and I roll my eyes every time I hear it too. But it's a way to really just celebrate and get together. Our intention as a company is to make people feel good. And, our hope is that when we make people feel good, that they won't forget about us when it comes time to buy or sell a home. But we don't need to sell anybody. We just need to be good people. And hopefully that law of attraction will rise the tide for us.
So when you plan this together, your team put this together at Hatch Realty. I was there last year, and I remember then campaigning for Governor Doug Burgum stopped by your event to shake a few hands. Did you ever imagine that it would turn into, you know, a thing where 1,500, 2,000, 3,000 people would show up to your parking lot?
When Doug Burgum shows up, because it's the place to be, I think we haven't figured out and we've cracked the code. And in fact, I saw Doug a few days ago, and he asked me if we were doing Hatchstock again. And just fun to have a little place in the heart of the governor of North Dakota. And we never expected Hatchstock to grow in the infancy to as big as it has. But that's been kind of our MO, Jason, is that as we've done everything with Hatch Realty, we've had faster growth than we ever expected. This is a superb community to build, to risk, to try, and folks seem to be investing in us as we're investing in them, and that's such a great gift. But we're expecting, again, up to 2,000 people or so in our parking lot on Friday, June 2nd, and it's an open invitation for everybody. If you want to come and hang out, 5 to 10 p.m., free food, live music, great entertainment, and inflatable games for kids and adults who aren't as heavy as me. So it's a pretty great opportunity. All we need people to do, Jason, is to go to livefargomorehead.com to sign up, so we have enough food on hand. Again, livefargomorehead.com if you want to sign up for Hatchstock, so we keep the food stocked and the tacos coming.
To listen to the Erik Hatch interview or other exclusive interviews, visit our website, oilfieldreport.com. That's oilfieldreport.com. And while you're there, be sure to sign up for our weekly newsletter. We're also on social media. Check us out at Facebook, follow us on Twitter, and subscribe to our YouTube channel. All those links can be found at our website, oilfieldreport.com. And do not forget to support our fine sponsors here at the Oilfield Report. They allow programs like this to happen and literally do keep our lights on.
The Oilfield Report is sponsored by
Junior Urias, owner and operator of Up and Smoke Barbecue. He's been out barbecue mastering the opponents for decades in West Texas. In fact, he was the 2014 Barbecue Pitmaster Texas Champion, and he loves to outseason the competition every chance he gets. Junior Reyes and Up and Smoke Barbecue. Erik Hatch is in the business of helping others, and in this case, that means helping companies like yours create wealth and abundance. Erik Hatch speaks on workplace culture, honesty in the workplace, transparency, faith, compassionate capitalism, and many other topics that will grow your business. CoachingWithHatch.com. That's CoachingWithHatch.com. Lashaw Drill understands the importance of what we do every day. Their customers understand it too. The men and women of Lashaw Drill believe in the mission of American energy independence. They believe in their people, and they believe in their country. Lashaw Drill. Once again, folks, I'd like to thank you for listening to the Oilfield Report. My name is Jason Spiess. I'm an award-winning multimedia journalist, and that was the Oilfield Report. Till next time, be safe and be happy.